Our voices are dominated, overwhelmed by other voices. That's why what you have done today, you have shown us that you can produce knowledge. And this is what we are supposed to do. We cannot simply continue sharing other people's knowledge. We must produce our knowledge. And this is the best way to influence the world. And this is the best way to spread our Islamic message to the world. I will conclude with one small message. I was reading a book the other day. The title of the book is Decolonizing Education. It's written by a Canadian scholar named Mary Batista. She is a Canadian, but indigenous Canadian, not migrant from Europe. And she said that when she went to university, she had some shock. She couldn't put herself in the university environment. She didn't fit there. Why? Because the book she was reading at university, she uses that as a mirror. Do not mirror her background. Do not reflect her background. And then she uses another term, fragmented existence. When she goes to university, she has one existence. At home, she has a different existence. Because the home environment is indigenous Canadian environment. And the university environment is highly influenced by European values, European culture. Whether we admit it or not, all of us are having this fragmented existence. When we go to our homes, our masses, among our family members, our parents, we have one existence. When we come to university, we encounter American literature, Western literature, we have a different existence. So at this university, what we try to do is to reconcile, to try to find some kind of common ground between these two existences. And that is the way we make a bridge between these two existences is to look at it from our cultural experience, from our religious experience. Whatever we study, we look at it from Islamic perspective. And this is how we try to have a sense of belonging to the subject that we study. Otherwise, we will continue to have this fragmented existence. And I ask my students in the very first class, I ask them, I teach you English literature. Do you know who gives my salary? Is it the British government? They say, no. And I say, the British government should pay me. Because I promote British culture. I promote British authors. So the British government should pay me. But they will not give me a penny. But I have been promoting British culture, British values, British authors. So this is a lost project. Unless we look at this English literature, American literature from Islamic perspectives. So please let us not forget about our root, our identity. Sometimes we simply go with the flow. We tend to imitate other people. Mimicry or imitation is a disease. And it's difficult to cure this disease because the disease is so deep. It's very difficult. But if we have a strong Islamic foundation, Islamic knowledge, inshallah, this disease will be cured. But please, let us not serve someone else's purpose. Let us serve our own purpose. We don't have time to waste. We employ our time, money, energy on this subject. And at the end of the day, if we promote someone else's culture by this subject, then this is a lost project. So I hope we will continue to produce knowledge and will continue to dominate the world through knowledge, not through demonstration and fighting, through knowledge. Our task is in our reading room, in our library. And this is our battlefield, as I said, warriors. We are the warriors in the battlefield of knowledge. With this, I conclude. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Thank you. Thank you.